Hi, this is Elizabeth here, back again with another installment of RoughDraft DIY. I've got another great idea that's easy to make. You might have already seen it in the background of some of my other videos. Actually, it's the simplest project I've filmed yet because it doesn't need a single nail or screw. It's just a bookshelf made from cinder blocks and boards. Now you might say no one needs directions making this bookshelf. We all made it in college. But I'm going to show you how to make this economical design using potted plants and a paintbrush. But first things first, you'll need some supplies. You'll want to get 10 cinder blocks. They cost less than $2 a piece at a hardware store, and look for blocks that measure 8 by 8 by 16 inches. For a more aesthetic approach, grab blocks that have one smooth side and one indented side. This is so that during assembly, the exterior part of the blocks on the bookshelf will be uniformly flat, and so that the interior part of the block will be flush with the books. Next, get 5 1 by 8 boards that are about 6 feet long. That's 4 boards for the shelves, and a 5th board that will be cut down to act as a support spine and boosters, but we'll get into that later. Pinewood tends to be the cheapest, oak is stronger, but any of them will do as long as the board has the same width as the cinder block. Then you'll need a gallon of primer, a gallon of paint in the color of your choice, some wood stain also in the shade of your choice, and 10 flower pots and plants that fit snugly into the holes of the cinder blocks. The first step is painting the cinder blocks to make them more, well, presentable. But before we can do that, we have to prime them. Cinder blocks are very porous, meaning paint will absorb into the rough surface instead of covering it. So 2 coats of primer will give us a smoother surface that's ready for paint. And go cheap on the paintbrush, otherwise the rough surface will tear up one of your good brushes. After the primer is dry, give it 2 coats of paint, and you're done with half the preparation. Now moving on to staining the boards. Say you couldn't find the exact shade of wood stain you had in mind. There isn't nearly the amount of variety in wood stain as there is in paint. One might be too yellow, another not red enough, or one that's way too dark. What you can do is mix any of the colors to get the one you want. A good trick to ensure accurate measuring is to use eyedroppers. Start with several units of the lighter shade, then add the darker shade bit by bit so it doesn't overwhelm the mixture. Test it on the back of the board to make sure you like the color. Then remember the ratio so you can reproduce the exact same shade in case you run out before you're done staining. Don't forget to wipe off the excess stain so you get the best idea of how your new color will really look once it's dry. Once you've got the right color, actually applying it is easy. Give the board a thin coat, wait about 10 minutes, and then wipe the board down with a cloth. Wait until the top side of the board completely dries before staining the bottom. To avoid overlapping stain around the edges and corners, only apply stain right up to the edge. Then take a dry brush or cloth to help fill it in. Once everything is dry, it's ready for assembly. Remember that board we used for testing wood stain? Use it for the base of the shelf. Place the test plot face down and no one will ever know. Then place a cinder block on either end of the board, making it flush with the front and ends. The first shelf we're going to make will be the tallest one that can fit large books and records. We'll make it by staggering 2 cinder blocks on the outer edges of the first blocks, just over the halfway mark so they won't tip over when you let go. Then place a board on top, keeping the outer holes of the cinder block exposed. Next, place 2 cinder blocks on the inside and a board on top of them. Already we've created a couple of functioning shelves, the bottom one for larger books and records, and the one above it is a perfect fit for pocket editions that are typically 6 inches tall. But a lot of my books are larger editions and slightly taller than my cinder blocks. So to make a slightly taller shelf, I'm going to make boosters by cutting 2 8x8 inch pieces off the 5th board. If you don't have a miter saw at home, you can ask them to do it at the store. Most places that sell lumber will also custom size it for free. Place the boosters on the inner halves of the top 2 blocks, then put a board on top, and finally the last 2 cinder blocks. At this point I thought my bookshelf was complete. Then I noticed that the top shelf was starting to sag under the weight, which could become a problem if it starts to rest on the books. So I suggest adding a central spine for support. Use the remainder of the 5th board for the pieces. One cut will need to be the length of 2 blocks stacked, then just 1 block, then 1 block plus the booster. I wish I could give you exact measurements, but although the blocks and boards are marked with the standard 8x8x16 or 1x8, they often fall just short of these measurements. Make sure you measure at least twice before cutting, and once again, you can have someone at the store cut it down for you. Use painter's tape to mark the exact center, And once you slide in the supports, the structure is finally complete and you can add the books and plants. Thanks for watching, and as always, please like this video or leave a comment below. I have 3 videos out now and more on the way, so subscribe to my channel for more DIY ideas, and we'll see you next time.